Hello everyone, I'm Emilia Mao. I'm a Hungarian painter who lives in Italy, close to Bologna. I'm transgender heterosexual woman. I hope we have met before and maybe later too. If you like this video, thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Yeah, I had many topics in my mind, but today is my mother's birthday, so I'm talking about podcast which I have seen after a Hungarian film came out. I don't know in English it's available or not. It was Tommy's Color. He's a transgender man. Well, actually he's at the moment gender fluid, she thinks. And the film is about the family of her mother, her father, the brothers and sisters, everything. But the podcast, it was about how managed that the mother. How she felt during this story, because it's a real story and they actually make a documentary of this family, so it's not a story about fiction. And I have seen and I was deeply impressed, because the mother was really intelligent. They had a really hard life. They try to be on the side of the girl who became a man and now a girl again, and how she react and had his fight in herself. So of course that side of the story I have never really talked, because I'm the children. But I found it deeply impressive and emotional and really sensitive. I told to my mother, if you have time and if you think you are interested, you can watch, because maybe it's give you answers, because it's another parents whose child was transgender, is transgender. Because my mother first reaction was, when I said I want to make the transition, I should keep in secret, and that makes me extremely angry, because all my life was about honesty and she asked me to lie. And I was thinking for a few months on it, and then I personally told to my father and for my sister and later others what's gonna happen with me. And yeah, the angriness not really went away. Then I lost my closest relatives, my grandma. And I was situations which was bothering me really, because on the funeral my grandma was highly respected by the society. She was a teacher for 40 years. She knows everyone in the city. She was someone who many people loved. So many people came for the funeral. And my mother couldn't know what she should do, how she should behave and so on, because also her friends arrived who has no idea about me. And I was already a woman. Look like a woman, or I hope so. And she just became completely distracted. And I tried to not make a big deal about it, because I thought, okay, it's a new situation for her. She must try. I mean, she's trying, so that's the most important thing, and I should not care. But I felt she really can't get it. I mean, can get it what she should do, or how she should feel. And I thought this podcast may help. Because the mother was so sad first. She was looking for something which she can mix for us. And she thought, how is possible? She didn't realize her doctor, which she really care also, it's not a family, you know, where children live together with the parents, but actually no connection at all. No, she was really care, and still she ignored all the signs which may tell her she should manage maybe different her than she imagined, or maybe she is a different person than she wished for with the best intention. So, and because also I talked, my mother had this house already when she talked I'm homosexual, was a big question, how is possible? I was 27. No, I don't want to lie. I came out officially to my mother. So now it's 18 years. I don't know how old I was. But it was before the first child I born of my sister. We was walking to the supermarket and we was talking about how happy we are. And I told to my mother because it was a kind of necessary, because I wanted to move together with someone and in the same street where she lived. And this city was pretty small, so actually never mind where I was to be with this guy, it came out pretty fastly. So I told her, yeah, but you know, from me you cannot expect a grandchild. And I thought I did it well, because she not really made reaction and so on. And then my sister was calling me in a half hour when I already was alone somewhere and telling me how cruel you could be. Because my mother was really devastated, and then she called my sister, and of course she let her desperation and sadness over on her, and of course dramatized a little bit how it happened, because for her could not exist a way to tell in the right way. But she didn't want to hurt me, that's really my mother. So she thought for someone, of course, in a big family, it's come around, you know, and in time you will know. How fast is depend, because there was happening, which I have known after 5-6 years, because nobody wanted to tell me what was actually happening, but usually it's pretty fast. So she was already surprised how she could not know it, and I was surprised how she got that shock. Because if you have seen my previous video, and you can search around, I did talk about my childhood and teenagerhood when I was still with my parents. And I actually was wearing makeup, and I actually was dressing nearly like a woman. I wore man clothes officially. But on me, I always choose man clothes, which looks like woman clothes. I know, it's tricky. I know I have no one, so as I also have told, I was 23, already living alone, and I have someone finally. Not even secret love, nothing really, because it stopped me, you know, I had to keep him in a way secret. But in the other hand, I was pretty public. I mean, everyone knew it. So, in the village where we lived, in the city, in the school. And my mother didn't understand how she could not see it. And that's what the same with the transgender things, I mean. And this woman also, the mother of the transgender man, or gender fluid, sorry. It's even hard for me. It's so many possibilities. I'm not familiar with gender fluid, so excuse me, I apologize, it's not an offense. It's just something which I have no experience, like other people has no experience with transgender. But she also said how different phases became. So for example, the first phase was she said she's lesbian. She was not taking easy, but in a way she processed this matter. And then she said maybe she's transgender. And when the time arrived, she wanted actually the operation to take away the breast. Mastectomy? No. I don't want to say stupid things, I made the descriptions. She was really worried because she was thinking, oh my god, that's my beautiful girl. It's fine, he's dressed like, she's dressed like how she does, and so on, but that's something which her beautiful body, which I was always so happy about, it became damaged. And then comes, she said actually before the operation, she feel she is transgender fluid, so not even transgender. And she felt she is mistreated. She felt her child was lying. And for her was happening, there was friends who had also transgender child, told what they were actually transgender. They told her, no, it's a way, it's a journey, and we often don't know from the beginning what we are. We have to have the experience. And it's not because they want to pretend something, it's just because they just have not the knowledge. And yeah, in my case, like I said, I always know I'm a woman, but I had no idea what transgender is. I had no idea until I got moved to Italy, when actually I was over 30. I just not met with it. I'm a woman, and other ones think I'm a feminine homosexual guy. But for all my partners, I always said a woman, but I didn't use the term I'm transgender because it's also true, I didn't have dysphoria. I felt I'm a woman and I didn't want to hurt my body. I was not depressive. I was sad sometimes when I had to happen the breakup because they find out I'm a woman. And we said goodbye with friendship, but it didn't make me, you know, break down. It's strange because COVID made me, but that's another story. So I hoped, and my mother watched it more, and she said it would actually really give her answers, because she had same questions like this woman, this mother. And yeah, my connection with my mother was not satisfactory on my side, but I'm quite sure on her side was not true, because I always wished a mother which she couldn't be. It was not her fault, and it's like I always tell her, I'm old enough to understand what was happening. I'm old enough to realize I actually doing the same mistakes like her. Unfortunately, I don't have children. Maybe for the children it's a fortune, but my childhood was not unhappy, so I cannot complain. And I see my mother really try. I mean, small steps. I told her she don't have to understand. She was never transgender. I was never in her skin. I mean, we have complete different life experience. I'm not expect to understand me. I like we talk. For me, it's important, and it's good, I think. And we accepted the way each other. I accepted the things which I could do different in her life, but I know it's her life. And she accepted my mom. So happy birthday to my mother. And I hope she will be healthy for a long time. And I think we process the things relatively well. Like, of course, I cannot compare with other ones. But I can compare with my father, which I was telling her this morning when I had said happy birthday. I had an impulse a few days ago. I don't know how it came. I had an impulse, an angry impulse to write him and write him. It was not right what he did. And I was surprised because the actually what happened is happened in June, so not yesterday, in June. And I buried it. I mean, then it made me really feel sad, not angry, sad, deeply sad. But I buried and I tried to not think on it because I know my father also if he don't live. And then happened things in the last few days which made me really angry about him because I realized politically we have the same view, which pretty liberal and pretty empathic. I realized my father, even when I'm adult, he cannot manage to not show how he disagreed. No, he humiliated me. I cannot say in a different way. Humiliate me in front of a family which not mine because it's my sister and her family, but we don't know each other. We have not seen each other for a long time because I realized when I told him I'm transgender and I do actually the transition, it was too much for him. He tried to hide it because he tried to be civilized most of the time. But of course I sent it, and after that I asked directly before I left them, and then I let him time to process. But it's past 3 years and I have not seen him 3 years. And then we talk in a family fest and he humiliated me in the most personal way. He said, why I play feminine voice and whatever, because I'm just a man. I try to not care, you know, it was not a day, you know, when I should react heavily and stand up for myself. But it was just surprising, it was just like when I was 6 years old. And I was not imagining, you know, if you do like this. And not in front of, I said again, dangerous. For me it's dangerous. And I get angry and I said, no, it's no way. Actually, if I think back in my whole childhood, I respect him and I know he is a good man, but exactly with us, with my sister and me, he was not a father. He do for everyone which he actually should do for us. I never could count on him. And that hit me. And then I get real angry because I was thinking, I never could count on him. He don't want to see what is my life and my reality when he's so politically on my side. So how far is that? When his own family cannot accept the differences. And I thought I write him, I'm really sorry, I still not think he's a bad person, but like father, he was an absolute failure, and I hope that like grandfather is better. Fortunately, he's not so challenging like I was, still challenging, like every parent is challenging. But, yeah, But finally I decide no, it has no meaning because he will not understand, he will ignore the point and he will just get hurted, so I didn't do that. I don't know. I don't say I buried the stuff, but that's which we are not gonna happen, you know. I think I gave him the chance to really digest I am who I am, if he's interested. But I also realized, I'm sorry, in my whole life he was never really interested what I'm doing and what success I had and what problems I had. When my mother said, why am I not talking with my father, I always said, yeah, we don't have anything common to talk. But it meant for me, he's not interested. You know. So that's the other side of the family. Today I was think maybe it's proper to talk about because it's really my mother's birthday. So let's finish like this. Happy birthday, my mother. Ciao everyone. If you like my video, thumbs up. If you have anything to share with me, then please write in the comment section and yeah, subscribe.